Welcome to the sixth video of the Blender 2.8 Beginners Tutorial Series. In this video, we will UV unwrap the apple and the knife for our 3D scene. As always, you can find the timestamps of this video in the video description below. And if you want to follow along, sign up to our resource section free of charge, where you can download all the project files, our handy Blender 2.8 shortcut PDF, and other helpful resources. The link you find down below in the video description. Hi everyone, Zach here for CGBoost.com. And let's get started. If you're not familiar with the term UV unwrapping or UV mapping, this process helps us to put a 2D image onto a 3D mesh. In this process, the mesh will be unwrapped onto a flat 2D plane. Imagine a cardboard box, which you cut on the edges and then lay it flat on the ground. Now it's very easy to paint on that, then you can put it back together, and then you have a nice 3D painted cardboard box. In Blender, you won't actually unwrap the 3D model, so you won't see your model unwrapped in the 3D viewport. However, you will define seams where the mesh should be cutted, and then you run the UV unwrapping process, which happens behind the scenes. And then in the UV editor, you will see the final unwrapped model, which is also called UV map. UV stands for the XY coordinates of a 2D plane. Then you can place a 2D pixel-based image underneath the UV map, then paint above the UV map, and then you will see this nice texture on your 3D model. Okay, now let's have a look how this UV unwrapping process works in detail. Alright, before we start the UV unwrapping process, please again make sure that all of your object has a scale value of 111. So select all the objects, and if one of those objects don't have this, press Ctrl A and apply the scale. I mentioned this 100 times already, but it's so important. And also for UV unwrapping, if the scale value is non-uniform, this will cause trouble. So do yourself a favor and do that. You can also simply select everything and press Ctrl A and click on apply scale. Now let's go over to the UV editing workspace. Depending on what you have selected, you will automatically switch over to edit mode. But let's quickly go back to object mode, because first of all, I want to show you one thing. If I select the claws, tap into edit mode and select everything, you can see over here in the UV editor that this object already has a UV map. And that's because if I tap back to object mode, add, for example, a cube, all the default objects, if I open this down here, have an automatic generated UV already when this is enabled. So if I tap into edit mode of the cube, you can see we have a perfect UV map over here already. So and the same thing applies to the claws here. This was a simple plane as I added this, and also a simple plane has a UV map already, as you can see. So we don't need to create a UV map for this. So that means we can simply hide this. Then for the bowl, we also don't need a UV map, because for this we will only use procedural textures, which are computer generated. What this means you will learn in one of the next videos. So let's hide this as well. And for the wooden planks over here, we will use an automated way to place textures onto the model. And what this means you will also learn later on. So let's hide this as well. The only two objects we need to manually unwrap are the apple and the knife. So let's select the apple, press Alt G to recenter this, and let's also move this knife a bit closer here. So when I select the apple, tap into edit mode and select everything, you can see that this has some kind of UV map already, because we started with a UV sphere and this has an automated generated UV map already, as I showed you with the cube. But we can simply ignore this because we want to generate a new UV map. So first of all, if I deselect everything here by simply left clicking somewhere and just select a few vertices, you can see that over here we only see the vertices which we have selected. When you're starting out with UV mapping, this can be quite confusing. So what I do recommend, at least for now, is to enable this little button here, which basically synchronizes the 2D view, the UV editor, and the 3D view in terms of what we select. So if I select something over here, this will be selected here as well, and the other way around, as you can see. And in this way, you always see the full UV map also when you don't have everything selected over here. So in order to create a UV map, what we need to do, let's go to edge selection. We need to select edges and define them as seams. so the UV editor knows how to unfold or unwrap the model. So for the apple, I already tried this. What I do, I hold down Alt and left click to select a loop over here. Then with Shift, Alt and left click, I select this loop. Then this one here and this one. So I hold down Alt and Shift. Then I can select multiple loops. And in order to mark these edges as seam, I simply right click and click on Mark Seam. If you, for example, accidentally marked some edges as seam, you can simply select these, right click and click on Clear Seam to remove the seams. Then let's press L with the mouse above the apple and press H to hide this. So we have a better view on to the stem here. Now let's Alt left click select this loop over here and with Alt Shift this loop. Then right click Mark Seam and now press Alt H to unhide the apple. Now we need to start the unwrapping process. For that important, we need to select everything with the A in edit mode and then we go to UV and simply click on unwrap. You can see immediately this was unwrapped depending on where we set the seams. What we can do down here is to change the margin between those islands. So each of those areas are called islands, UV islands. So we can change the distance. And over here, if I disable this again, we have some options to select. And for example, this over here allows us to simply with left click select whole islands. And same as in edit mode or in object mode in the 3D viewport, we can use G for moving around. When something weird like this happens, then we have proportional editing still enabled. So let's disable this. Now, if I move this around, you can see I can change the position or the rotation with R and with S even the scaling. But I don't recommend to simply scale single islands and place them somewhere here, because the size of the islands are now matching each other. That means the size of this face, for example, represents the size of the face here on the apple. And this has the right size also dependent on all the other islands. So if you want to scale this, you have to select everything and scale everything so that you don't have a higher resolution on one area and a lower resolution on another area. So now what I try to do is to place these islands in the best way possible so that they use the most possible space of this square here. So I press R for rotating this, scale this, and then with the island selection enabled, I select the single islands and move them around. With left click, you can place these and make sure that none of the islands overlap each other, because when I paint this area here, then the same color will be applied to this area over here. So it's important that everything is not overlapping each other. So I think we can scale this even more. Also, take care that we don't go over the edge here. So move this closer over here. So this looks quite good, I think. Let's tap out of edit mode. If you like, you can simply hide the apple. And maybe let's simply press Alt G with the handle selected and recenter this. So now we have a little problem because the knife consists out of two objects, the blade and the handle. But here in Blender, we can simply select two objects and with Tab enter edit mode of both objects at the same time. Again, if I select everything, you can see we have some weird UV maps here, and that's because we started with cubes and they had the default UV maps already. So we can ignore this again. And for the unwrapping process, let's enable the sync function again. First of all, let's click somewhere here. With L, I select the blade and press H to hide it, so I have a better view here on the handle. Now edge selection is still enabled. Now let's Alt left click to select this loop, then with Shift Alt this one here, and also the two on the other side, and also these over here. And to make the UV unwrapping process as simple as possible, I basically just cut off each side. So all these are selected, right click, mark seam. Then let's press Alt H to show the blade. Now let's deselect this and with my mouse above the handle, press L to select this and H to hide this. Now we can focus on the blade. First of all, let's select this one over here. Then with Control left click this one, and then you can see the shortest way in between will be also selected. And if I hold down Control again, I can do it again over here. Then let's right click and mark this as seam. Let's do the same thing on the other side. With Control I select the whole line here, right click, mark seam. Then let's select this here, mark seam, and also these two over here, right click, mark seam. Now press Alt H to unhide everything. Select everything, that's important. Click on UV and unwrap. What you also can do is simply press U and then you have the same menu over here. You can simply click on unwrap. Now the margin down here is a bit big. Let's decrease this. And as you can see, this already places the islands pretty well. We have a lot of empty space over here, but since these are very long islands, I think it would take a while until we figure out a better way to place everything. So I think in this case, we just leave it as it is. Let's tap back to object mode, go back to a layout. Now we can simply save this. Hey guys, now you have a rough idea on how to use UV unwrapping in Blender. I hope this video makes the process clear. Certainly, the more complex your object gets, the longer the process and editing the UV map takes. Anyway, if you enjoyed this video, make sure to like, subscribe and leave a comment in a comment section below. And make sure to ring the bell underneath this video if you want to get notified for future videos. If you want to learn Blender 2.8 even deeper and want to make sure that you don't miss on important fundamentals, make sure to check out my Blender 2.8 Launchpad course, which I created with big attention to detail so that you have a full and deep understanding of the fundamentals of Blender 2.8 while creating a full animated scene from scratch. If you want to learn more, check the link in the video description. Thanks a lot for watching guys, now check the next video where we will use the texture paint mode to project paint images onto our models to have realistic looking texture details on the objects which we will use later on in our materials. I will see you there, goodbye.